And right now my Instagram's flooded with people just dancing on Saki Saki, attempting the hook step, doing their own choreography. Kids are doing it, older people are doing it. There are huge workshop videos that I've been seeing on Instagram, so it's quite crazy, yeah. Hi Nora, how are you?
Hi, thank you for having us.
First of all, congratulations for Saki Saki.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's good. Thank you, Saki. And you are here today.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So, Tulsi, you are known for this soulful and magical songs. So, how is it different to sing for a dance number like Saki
Saki? I've done a lot of dance numbers before also. So, I've done a song called Lambera Hitler, which came back in 2009, almost 10 years ago. And then there was Nachaki Sarila, there was Kalabi 2.0. But definitely, Saki Saki has grabbed all the eyeballs for all the right reasons. And it's kind of gotten me a lot of love and appreciation. Of course, the whole team, me, BHAVI, Tanish, and Nora, they're on the screen. So I think the whole combination has come out very beautifully. And as far as it goes, you know, my vocals, everyone's relates me to the soulful and the melodious numbers. But I think this was a challenge for me to kind of get out of my comfort zone and do something very different. And I'm happy that I am a part of Saki Saki. People are loving to hear the new side of those.
Last year, your song Bilbar Bilbar became a huge hit. So, did that success give you a little bit of, even a little bit of pressure for the performance?
Of course it did. I mean, after Bilbar followed up with Kamaliya, and after Kamaliya, I released the Arabic version of Bilbar. So, I feel like that pressure was there when Kamaliya was releasing, because it was actually immediately about maybe like 1 week after Tulsi or something was released. So there was pressure there, even though I had shot Kamaliya before Tulsi, but then the release happened that way. But yeah, and then of course when I did Arabic Tulsi, there was also a fear of, will this be accepted? I made it for a different market, but still I am working here, so I need things to work out for me here also, even though I'm creating something that's catering to a different market, the Arabic market. But the day before Arabic Dilbar was releasing, I was very, very stressed and scared. And then when it released, you know, people really, really received it well, and everyone really enjoyed it, despite being a different language. And then it did really well outside also. So that pressure and fear was a little bit less. And as we shot Saki, I was just more excited to offer something different visually and to take the dancing to another level in the song. But I think a day before Saki was releasing, again, that pressure came back to me all over again. And that's fear. It was more fear of, will this be as good as Dilbar? Like, you can't compare it to Dilbar because it's totally different. It's like two ends of a stick, you know what I mean? Visually and even sound-wise, even the dance style is very different. But it's about whether the audience will receive it the way they received your previous work. And I think that's the thing with all artists, which is normal. Some artists, their fear and pressure is less than other artists. Mine is just too much. So I was like really freaking out the day before it released. But then the day it released, I think after 24 hours, I knew we're heading towards the right direction. After 3 days, when you see people on social media making dance videos to it, doing their own workshops to the song, and people going to dance classes wanting to learn on the song, people posting their TikToks and all these, then you know it's a hit. Then you know people are really enjoying it. And right now my Instagram's flooded with people just dancing on Saki Saki, attempting the hook step, doing their own choreography. Kids are doing it, older people are doing it. There are huge workshop videos that I've been seeing on Instagram, so it's quite crazy, yeah.
Yeah, there's a lot of love.
Yeah. And people are singing it also.
Yeah.
By the way, singing
videos.
Yeah, they're everywhere. Yeah. And there's some people doing their like tabla stuff on it. And super.
So, to both of you, do you think that this in this particular time where digital is so huge, where social media is so huge, it helps the singers as well as performers like you?
Definitely. I think, you know, there was a point of time where you actually didn't know how your song is faring. Like, you know,
yeah, actually.
You didn't know, after maybe a span of a couple of days, you would know ki haan gaana maine riksha mein suna tha, wahan suna tha. Those were the parameters. Party mein chal raha tha, this pe chal raha tha. So, now it's like, it's all in front of you in social media, you know, the comments. The numbers, the views, the likes on the video, the dislikes, everything is like, you know, right there. And you get to know, like how even Nora said that, you know, with people, so many digital platforms like TikTok and YouTube and Instagram, people can do various things on the song and kind of post it out there. And then you know that your song is actually being loved and talked about. To the extent that you can also know now that which cities and, you know, the internal parts of India your song is faring even better, because you get all those stats on YouTube online nowadays.
And
so so I think there is a lot that digital media has been a boon to all of us and to all the artists, and I think it's amazing that we get to know the response of our songs immediately.
As a performer, for sure, I would say it's taken our work to another level, and the way we can engage with our audience, interact with our audience, it's a different
next
world.
Level.
And this is why whenever I do a project, like a dance number, for example, I make sure like the dance and the choreography is an engaging choreography. People will want to try it at home, they will want to try it at a dance class, they want to attempt it. It shouldn't be a video where you just watch it on YouTube and you're just like, oh, it's sexy. That's you know what I mean? It should be engaging, it should make you want to get up and like hit the next dance studio and attempt it. Yeah, it needs to be aspirational, it needs to be energetic, it needs to be engaging. And that's how I look at a lot of things, like even with Dilbar, when we did that hook step, that particular hook step, I made sure it's very belly dance, very authentic belly dance. And I remember there was an argument where it was like, okay, but should we really be doing something like this that may be tough for people? Like, how do we know that majority of people can attempt belly dance, you know? And somehow I was just like, let's just do it, because you know it's different and people want something different. And sooner or later, like once the song became a hit, all these girls, you know, their belly dancer within had come out, and they were doing the hook step so beautifully, and I'm just like, yes.
With that entire belt of the belly dancer,
they're like, let's do this, you know, and I was so impressed to see girls like with their confidence and just letting their hair down and attempting it, and that is my whole point, is like, don't underestimate the audience, don't underestimate the people, especially on social media. Youngsters are really, really, you know, at it. They're so talented, and the ones who, you know, may not be as good, they want to learn, and that desire is there. So we need to feed that desire. Like, gone are the days of just doing a song and just looking hot. It's like people are like, okay, whatever, boss, like, give me something, you know. So even with Saki, with that hook step, I wanted it to be a certain vibe where you look at it, you're like, okay, what did she just do? And then you rewind and you want to watch it again, and then first time you're like, nee, this is too difficult, I can't do it. The second time you're like, maybe I should try it. And then you try it and you're like, oh my god, yeah. And you call your friends and then you get everyone else to do it. It should be like that. That's how a song should that vibe should be there for the song.
That I know people who have tried that step of
that. Yeah, it's almost like a dare now. Like, where are you?
I did it yesterday. Finally yesterday.
Yeah. And I also want to mention, like, with social media and digital and all that, being able to perform as a performer and an artist, people being able to do promotions of a project with a singer is really important. And I started that with Hardy Sandhu and We Did Not. That was like the first time a singer and a performer joined together and went on this whole promotional tour. Like, we went on all these TV channels, all these media portals and outlets, and we promoted the song like that. And I felt so proud that you know, there is a face to it, like that you can actually see the singer.
Yeah.
Because for so long, everyone's like, okay, well, what does the singer look like?
Yeah.
And you just like, well, totally, you know what I mean? But now it's there's respect and dignity attached to who the face of the project is. And I did that last year with Tanishq and Tony also for Deva, now with Tulsi. So it's very important that people understand who are behind the project.
So would you consider Dilbar as a turning point of your life? Okay,
you know, for the longest time, I was like, yeah, Dilbar, Dilbar, because everybody was like, yeah, Dilbar is the reason why you're here. But you know, it's not, it's not. Hardy Sandhu ke saath jab wo gana aaya tha, it was the first song to reach 5 million views on YouTube in India. It broke a record. And at that time, I was just the girl from Big Boss and Chandak, you know. And people noticed me in that song, and filmmakers noticed me also. So I feel like secretly that is
that
what kind of propels.
Yeah.
Dilbar was the boom. So yeah.